Obviously, for a manufacturing facility, is some way to power anything. So it's a steam generation plant. It actually still serves as that purpose today. I'm not going to be giving a yelling tour the whole time because I'll lose my voice, but if you have any specific questions about anything, please come find me. This is 28, the building we were in, you know, with the theater and everything. There's actually no manufacturing purpose whatsoever for that building. It was built specifically for employee enjoyment. 20-lane bowling alley, a gun range. That's gone. Melted into the emulsions, or mixed, etc. It's 8 stories, and we'll show you. It actually goes 8 stories up over an automated bridge that takes the chemicals into the machine, and everything from that point on is automated. It's actually extremely sophisticated and unbelievable. This is the only film manufacturing plant for Kodak film left. So we used to have multiple of these, so film alleys. They, at one time, it was was at least six. Many of them are the buildings running down Ridge Road. Those are a lot of them that are sitting in a mothball state. The one that we've got, the latest one that was built right around the early 90s, is a billion-dollar machine. It's the size of the building. And so I always say, when you're looking at it, it's like a copier. So a copier, you get a paper jam, you open the little door, you get the paper out from that little spot. You're only seeing that little tiny spot of the machine itself. To really get in there, you've got to go deep. Same thing with this machine. When you open a door, you're in a room, you're walking down a hallway, you're not seeing the machine. There's miles of machine, miles of film running through the machine at any given time. It's unbelievably impressive. Don't take big groups like this through that.
Thank you.
ran out in front of everybody all the time on everything. So he was one of the first people to actually build an in-house R&D facility. And so that carried on, obviously, throughout all the years. Inventions that the company is responsible for. That's because he instilled that method from really, really early on. So you think OLED, OLED displays, those were invented here, the camera, tons and tons. Super glue, if you didn't have time to see in the visitor center, we cover a lot of the inventions that were worked on. In fact, the actual first digital camera, if you didn't see it, is in there, in the visitor center. So after we wrap up here, we're going to be open for another hour there. You can spend some time to peruse through that. Also, another thing to note in this area, there's a lot of buildings that are gone now. Keep in mind, this is the 1890s, right? So, horse-drawn carriage, right? Everything that you needed to move from one building to the next, you were either carrying it, pushing a cart, or having a horse take it to the next building. So everything was very, very close. The density was a lot tighter. You get towards the west end, things start to spread out a little bit more because we had the advent of trucks and other technology. One of the really cool things I'll show you over there is my favorite part of the park. There's an arch. And if you look down, there's an architectural feature that is, I forget what they're called. I got to look it up again. It protects the carriage hubs from taking out the brick masonry work on the bottom of the arch. So there's remnants of that here still. There used to be a massive building here, which was, I forget the number. Anyway, there was, it was a health building. So basically, you could go there, see a doctor, get your eyeglasses, do all that stuff, get a medical checkup, you know, somebody got hurt, it was EMS. It's a city in a city. We have our own fire department. We'll actually walk by one of the firehouses. All the equipment's been consolidated to the west end, but there used to at one time be three firehouses here. What's that? Yeah. Cool. And any open areas that you see, like I said, that was a building at one point in time. Especially when you see, so like the red brick that you see as landscaping, that is actually crushed brick and sandstone from the original foundations of brickwork from the buildings that came down. Any questions? I said I wasn't going to talk the whole time, but I am. Whatever.
Get off there, go through the gate. It's possibly work because I don't want to have to go for 20 minutes, half an hour. I went all the way over the line.
Sure did. Mr. Reed, if you want.
You want over here or do you want?
It's right here. It's where the bus stop is.
Thank you.
is what he's talking about. This is one of the original archways. And you see the two red triangles at the bottom?
Right here?
Oh, yeah.
Those are the carriages when whacked the brick.
yes, yes. And they wouldn't tell them what they were looking for. They just said, look for this object, or look for this person. Didn't know why, didn't know what they were doing, but they were scanning film. So a lot of surveillance stuff that we didn't really know why.
Yeah.